Welcome. I'm Dr. Melina Roberts, and I want to talk about something really important, which is sleep. Because sleep is one of the foundations of health, and you'll often hear me talk about how important sleep is, because during your sleeping hours, your body's doing a lot of its repair, it's doing a lot of its detoxification. It's really vital for many different functions in the body in order to keep our cells functioning well, to help keep your hormones in balance, to help our bodies to regain energy and rejuvenate. So many different important functions in terms of our sleep. And our sleep is also one of the big contributing factors to predicting the long-term health of our bodies. So if we're getting a good night's sleep, it does help to establish long-term health. So this is all really important things as to why sleep is so important. So sleep is one of those really important things, but I know that there's a lot of you out there that are not getting proper, ideal sleep. So I want to talk today about the five possible blocks to why you're not getting that great high quality sleep. So one of the possible blocks to why we're not getting into that deep restful sleep is that our adrenals can be stressed. Now adrenals, what they do is they release our body's stress hormones. So anytime we're under any sort of stress, we release these hormones to help our body combat that stress. So some of those things that can stress the body can be chronic mental emotional stress. If we have chronic inflammation in the body, so eating the wrong foods that cause inflammation, or if we have some joint pain that's causing inflammation in the body, or we can have a chronic infection. So these would be all things that would drain the adrenals, and potentially what can happen is that we can actually have a high cortisol level. And during our sleeping hours, our cortisol levels should actually come down. And what can happen is that if it's high during our sleeping hours, it can affect our ability to be able to get into that deep REM sleep, so that we are getting into that deep, high quality sleep where our body is doing all of that repair and rejuvenation and detoxification. And so one of the key aspects is that if our adrenals are stressed, we need to identify what's causing that stress in the body, and we also need to work on repairing and rebuilding those adrenals so that we can get those adrenals to be functioning better. So another reason why we may not be getting good quality sleep may be because our liver is congested. Now our liver is our body's major detoxifying organ. So any sort of toxin that comes in the body, that liver filters it, then it moves it out of the body. Now that liver can get congested quite easily because we live in a pretty toxic world, and there's a lot of toxins that that liver needs to be filtering and moving out, from the air that we breathe, the water we drink, from the foods that we're eating. We are taking in a lot of toxic load, and that liver can just get congested quite quickly. Now, the liver is quite active during our sleeping hours. That's when our body is doing the large amount of its detoxification. And the liver is actually the most biologically active between 1 a.m. and 3 a.m. So if people are waking up between 1 a.m. and 3 a.m., that typically is an indication that the liver is congested. So what we need to do is we need to work on decreasing that toxic load in the body. And the other thing that we need to do is we need to work on getting that liver to function better. And this will help get people into that good, deep, restful sleep, and also help the body to detoxify a lot better. So a third block to a good night's sleep can be melatonin disruptors. Now, darkness, being completely dark when you're sleeping, helps to stimulate melatonin production in the body. And melatonin really helps to make you feel sleepy and really get you into your deep, restful sleep when melatonin starts being produced in the body. And so some of those disruptors can be anything that's producing light. So if we have a clock beside us, if we have a phone that's emitting even just a little bit of light, coming through the eyelid can disrupt melatonin production. Another thing is that if even just a little bit of light is coming in through the windows, through a street light, this can actually be disrupting our melatonin production as well. So what we want to do is we want to make sure that we're sleeping in a really dark room. We want to cover all of those light sources in the room to make sure that the room is completely dark, because that's going to just help our melatonin be able to be produced and help us to get into that deep restful sleep. So the fourth thing that might be affecting our ability to get into that deep restful sleep can be the wrong temperature. Because during our sleeping hours, our core temperature actually decreases, and we need to be able to effectively admit that heat so that our body can just properly cool down. And so what can happen sometimes is that if we're sleeping in a room that's too warm, or if that we have a blanket that's not breathable and that heat can't escape and it's just keeping us actually too warm. So what we want to make sure we do is that we are sleeping in a room that it is a little bit lower than room temperature, so a cool room, and you also want to have a blanket on that's breathable. And when you do this, this can also help you to get into that deep restful sleep. And the fifth thing that can be actually contributing to potentially not getting into that deep restful sleep is poor digestion. So one thing can be is that if you are eating too close to going to bed at night and your body is still really focused on digesting your foods, or if you just have poor digestion, so even the dinner that you ate 3 hours ago is still being metabolized and broken down and your body's spending a lot of its energy trying to break down the foods that you're eating, then that can contribute to not being able to get into that deep restful sleep. So these are some of the things that can be contributing to why we're not getting into that deep restful sleep. And if it is poor digestion, what we need to do is something that we could potentially do is we can take digestive enzymes that does help our body to be able to break down the foods we're eating. And then long-term wise, we want to be able to heal the digestive tract by eating the right foods that our body can properly metabolize and help to heal up the digestive tract so it's functioning a lot better. So these are the things that we can do to help to improve your sleep. So often it's not just about taking some sleep aid before you fall asleep. It can be other factors that are happening in the body that can be affecting your ability to get into that deep restful sleep and have some good quality sleep. So thank you so much for listening. I hope you learned something today in this blog post, and I hope you will share this with your friends, that you will press the like button, make a comment below, and until next time, continue to learn, grow, and build health.